Chilli Farming Program. Chilli Farming is one of the five fingers of action in the Chilli Children project work. The Chilli Farming Program brings the project into contact with most of Rukungiri and Kanungu districts. 40 collecting centres are visited each year. The Chilli Program gives parents strong support and the means to make money from their small farm. For instance, the project helps with dryers, harvesting and selling the chilli. This diagram shows a day of selling chilli at a centre. The day starts with greetings and prayer, together with exchanging stories and information, including the progress of their disabled children. There follows a social hour on discussing farming ideas and problems. The farmers receive seedlings if required. This is when new recruits are welcomed. The chilli is then weighed. Next, it is checked and graded. This means that the farmers put their chilli on a large plastic sheet and it is inspected by the project. Each farmer is given a voucher for the quality and the weight of their chilli. New farmers are guided through the system. Warren checks the voucher and pays the farmer for his chilli. Then the farmer signs a receipt for the payment. Also, loans are made or checked. Last of all, Warren has a chat with the farmer and says farewell. Warren is in charge of the Chilli Farming Program. Also, he keeps an eye on farmers around Bugangari, while Zaire looks after farmers near Kisizi. David has the Kahihi area and Nelson has an area around Kebisoni. The chilli bushes are grown under banana plants together with maize, beans and sweet potatoes. Advice on growing, harvesting and drying the chilli is given, and this has led to the project's farmers producing some of the best chilli in Uganda. Larger established farmers are given help in building dryers, which are covered by a special plastic sheet. At the end of the harvest, a large lorry is hired to take the sacks of chilli to our exporter in Kampala, about 8 hours away. Warren and Nelson accompany the chilli to Kampala. Our exporter provides warehouse receipt financing, where the project are given a loan to cover the buying of the chilli. The project hand over the chilli to the exporter, which is then graded for colour and moisture contents, and a price is agreed and paid. The excess cash is used by the project to cover transportation and other costs such as dryers. Chilli was chosen as the cash crop by the project because it yields a high price per kilogram, which reduces storage and transport costs. Also, chilli is good for families who do not eat much of this bird's eye chilli themselves, as it is very hot. Here are three chilli farming stories. Alex, who needs a wheelchair, is a chilli farmer. He lives some distance away to the west near Kahihi. His farm is some distance from the road. As a small child, he had become an orphan, together with his two older brothers. The family of boys was helped by the project to cope with Alex. The boys continued to farm their banana plot. Often the family was short of food and the project would provide a sack of maize. The neighbours did what they could to help the boys. Also, near Kahihi, we visited a lady who is one of the project's best chilli farmers. This lady was not just a good chilli farmer. She kept her small farm very productive. She kept goats and chickens, and these provided milk and eggs and manure for the farm. The animals are kept in raised coops with slatted floors to allow the animal dung to drop through and to be used to fertilise her crops. This farmer has dark red chilies that are in very good condition. Her chilli dryer is covered in a special sun-resistant plastic that is obtained through the project. The chili is dried for 3 days when it is sunny, but if it is raining, then it may take 5 days or more to dry. Next is Isaac. Isaac had an operation on his cleft palate when he was 4 years old. As a young teenager, he grew chilies and was able to buy a goat for himself. Later, he bought a bicycle, and later still, a cow. By now, his harvests weigh several kilos. Recently, he had a second operation on his palate. Project worker Nelson has organised his farmers into a group, and this is their calendar. The members put some of their money into the group scheme. Any of the farmers can use these group savings to purchase expensive items, but have to pay it back with interest added. This may be called a microfinance scheme by some. It helps that Nelson is now trained and experienced in handling accounts. What a boon all this is to the poor farmers with a child in need to have this support program set up for them. As you have seen, the project are involved in the families and the communities in several ways over a large area. Often the project visits a community 3 or 4 times a year. When the trustees arrived in Uganda in 2014, the harvest was being collected, but the project's lorry had broken down and the ambulance was being used to collect the harvest. Both are old vehicles and they need to be replaced. Further information about the trust and the project and how to make a donation is on our website and in our newsletters and the introductory leaflet. Please help us with your prayers and donations. Thank you.